Hey programmers, welcome to the first video in my series of grandMA3 for grandMA2 programmers, where we'll look at everything through the context of our experience with the MA2. Even though this first video is about hardware, it's still going to be useful information even if you're just using onPC. Most of the stuff that we talk about is going to be represented somewhere in onPC, and it's a good idea to have a handle on the terminology and what everything does. Also, I'm going to be using the demo show file that's included with all of the software so that we can all be on the same page. Like I've said before, the software is in active development, so always check the release notes so that you can be up on the changes for whatever version you're using. For reference, I'm using version 1.3.1.3 for this video. Let's talk about hardware. I know I covered some of this stuff in my video on how to run your grandMA2 show file on a 3, but this time let's go over the hardware and look at how it's going to work with the MA3 software. Fresh out of the road case, we got to pull out these transport locks, and don't forget to put them back in before you put it back in the road case. Then just pull up on the screens. No MA plus the up and down keys needed anymore. Screen-wise, we've got multi-touch touch screens, letterbox screens, and command screens. The internal keyboard is more centered now. There's also a keyboard symbol in the command line if you want to bring up the on-screen keyboard. Some other windows will also have a keyboard option. And if you go to name something and don't see an on-screen keyboard or an option, there might be a little arrow that will drop down and give you the keyboard. Unfortunately, there are no more storage drawers. But there is a little space in with the keyboard for your USB key. There's also USB ports in the back and one just below the armrest. There's no longer any trackball, but you can add a USB one if you like. On the encoders, they're all dual ring. When you're working with fixture attributes, the inner ring is course control, and you can hold this down while turning to go faster. And the outer ring is now fine control. Want to bring up the calculator? You can still click on the attribute on screen like the MA2. Also, you can still press the inner encoder. There's now a third option, which is pressing this little button called the dual encoder key. The fifth encoder is still, by default, a screens encoder. The inner wheel moves us up and down, and the outer left and right. You can tap the inner wheel or the dual encoder key to edit a cell. In MA3 software, you now have the option to change this encoder to be a fifth attribute encoder if you prefer. The GrandMaster is now this little rotary knob to the right of our encoders and above our power button. You can also roll it up and down on the screen. If you don't like the knob or using the screen, you can assign it to an executor. Pressing the GrandMaster title on the screen will enable or disable the master. And if you really don't want that knob to do anything, there is a config window that we'll come to in a moment where you can turn off that functionality. Under our encoders is our command section. There's still a level wheel present on the right and the numeric keypad that we all know and love. In fact, most of the keys should look pretty familiar. Of course, they've just been moved around. Those of us that have used multiple consoles in our career know that this isn't the big deal that some people make it out to be. You will acclimate. And you might even find that there are a couple of things that you like better. For example, having the next and previous keys closer to your encoder wheels. There's now two MA keys instead of one. Both still function like a shift, but there's easier access for some presses, like the second function of the X keys, and there are some new commands that need both MAs to be held. For example, one of the many ways to lock and unlock the desk is to hold MA plus MA plus the pause fix key. And not to worry, you can still use the pause key on your keyboard. There's also a lock button on screen, and just for fun, you can also unlock it by hitting the four corners in any touchscreen, starting at the top left, then bottom right, top right, and bottom left. Something new to us is going to be the up and down keys. Now, these aren't the same up and down keys to move us around within a sheet. These up and down keys are specifically for use when we're navigating fixtures that have subfixtures, which is something that we're going to talk more about in a future video. If you were looking for those traditional up, down, and left and right keys, just hold MA and use the number key with the corresponding arrow. Still in the command section, there's the right and left command screens. The left command shows us what's stored on the X keys and the rotary knobs, and probably feels a lot like the multi-touch on the MA2. Both screens are really just more user configurable space that we can store more views to. And if you need even more space on the left command screen, you can turn off the X keys playback bar. Playback on the MA3 obviously looks a little bit different than it did with the 2. We still have buttons, we still have faders, but now we also get the rotary knobs. Just like the 2, everything is configurable, but now we have the option for more playback sequences on one page. On the MA2, we had separation between the bottom row of our executor buttons and the executor masters with the faders above. The top two buttons, the fader and the key below it, were all using the same assignment. On the MA3, they're more separated, but at the same time, they don't have to be. Let me explain. On the bottom row are individual executor buttons that start at 101. Above that is a button and fader combination that represent executor 201 and up. Above there is one row of a button plus a rotary knob that equals executor 301 and up. And above that, again, another row of a button and rotary knob that start at executor 401 and so on. So on this one column, you could have four different sequences assigned. But say you wanted your executor fader to respond to not only the button below, but also the buttons and or the rotaries above. You can totally do that. Remember how we could extend the width of an executor on MA2? Well, we can of course still do that in the 3, but now we can use the same concept to extend the height of these executors as well and add in the top buttons and knobs to the executors with faders. And of course, we still have X key playbacks. The bottom row represent executors 191 through 198, and the top row are executors 291 through 298, and they get the extra rotary knob as well. To the right of our executors, we've still got our master section. The go, go back, pause, and the two configurable faders are exactly as we remember, but now we also get two extra keys and two extra rotary knobs. The smaller MA3 consoles don't get these top keys and knobs, but they can be accessed on screen with the Custom Master Section Window, which is a window option under More in the Add Window pop-up. If you do prefer to use any of the hardware options on screen, then you'll want to tap the MA in the top left corner and turn on the hardware options you want to control. This could be handy if you're on a smaller console and you don't have all of the master keys, or the custom section, which are additional configurable encoders and keys that are only on the largest grandMA3 consoles. And to configure any of these special executors, you'll want to go to the Special Executor Configuration menu. Besides using the assign key or touching an on-screen assignment for a special executor, you can also get to that configuration window by clicking on any of the options here in the Custom Master Section window. Earlier, I mentioned that you could disable the rotary knob of the GrandMaster. This is the window where you could do that if you need to. After all that, we still have to talk about the back panel. The good news is I don't even have to get up to show you what's back there. If I go to the command line and type menu connector view, please, I'll get the connector overlay on the letterbox screens. Not only does this show me what's on the back panel, but it actually lines up with where these ports are on the back, so no more blindly feeling around to find the right port. Now onto these connections. They're pretty straightforward. Desk lights, power, DMX, MIDI, display ports for external monitors, LTC, USB 2 and 3 ports, DC remote, audio in, SPDIFs, and 3 Ethernet ports, all of which could be configured for MANET, ARTNET, or SACN. When you're done with the connector overlay, just hit escape. So, not so hard to get used to the hardware changes from the MA2. In the next video, we'll start looking at software, see what's new, what's changed, and how to get around in it. Thanks for watching.